Okay, the double piston extender is at least working. That's good. What's up, agents? Zero here. Welcome back to some more New Lands S&P. This is episode 6, and if you remember last time, I went through the Nether with Mitch Apex, and we got a few materials, mainly glowstone, and, well, actually only glowstone and quartz, I should say, not mainly. But yeah, this episode, I actually have some redstone work that I want to do, but before I go ahead and do that, I want to show you guys, I actually got this thing up and working. The only thing I was missing as of last episode was a comparator, which means I needed quartz in order to do that. So, what I plan to do in this episode, as I just mentioned, I'm going to be doing some redstone work, which is something I have technically been doing quite a bit of off camera. However, I've not really done any on camera, and I actually have everything I'm going to need in order to get this set up, all things considered. So I've got absolutely everything that I'm going to end up needing. Actually, I do not need this lever, so I'm going to need all of this stuff, and I should probably go ahead and organize my inventory just a little bit. So the first thing I'm going to do is I actually need to pull out this pickaxe, and I'm going to actually mine out this section of the floor, because I actually went ahead and did some digging room in order to be able to work down here. That's why I have as much space down here as I do. And I've got pretty much everything I'm going to need in order to go ahead and get this project going. Now, some of you might be wondering what I'm actually going to be making in this episode. Well, actually, I'm going to be building my pop-up block swapper, if any of you guys remember what that thing is. Basically, what it does is you press a button, it pulls a block underneath the floor using a double piston extender, and then swaps the blocks around. And I decided I want to have one of those inside of my base. Now, I want to go ahead and place that there. I need to place that there. Then I need to go ahead and place a dirt block. Well, actually, it didn't have to be a dirt block, but it did need to be a block. And go ahead and do that. And if I go ahead and break that, I do, in fact, need to get back up to the top, because there's actually one thing of which I actually am going to end up needing in order to at least make this project look somewhat decent. And that's actually a staircase. Now, it doesn't necessarily really have to be a staircase. The only reason I'm using a staircase is simply because in that way I can at least block things off. And I just realized I need to turn this around, because otherwise I'm going to be able to see that side of the staircase. There we go, that's better. All right, so I've got pretty much everything I need, and I also am going to need to be able to get back up somehow, so I'm gonna need to go ahead and take out a few of these blocks, because once I have this built, I'm not gonna be able to get back up. And if I have that set up for me, then I should be fine. Actually, you know what, I could probably actually end up replacing that with smooth stone, because I do have some smooth stone. Yeah, it's right here, so I'm gonna grab that. And I need to go back down in here. And I'm going to be building this primarily out of dirt, because that's going to be a whole heck of a lot easier for me to build it out of. Plus I'll be able to just basically be able to break it by hand without a problem. So I need, no, not that. My cursor was not up high enough. So I need to place this repeater here. This needs to be set on 4 ticks. If I come back up here, this needs to be set on 1 tick. If I go ahead and take redstone dust, if I can grab it, there we go. That needs to go there. I need redstone dust to go right there. And then I need a block on top of this right here. So if I place that There we go. So now what I need to do is I need to get up here. I need to place a repeater. I actually need to be on this side to do this. So if I go ahead and place that there, I need a repeater to be right here with a block right there. There we go. Now what I need to actually do is I'm going to place a block down. Actually, I need to break this block first. But I do need a block right there. And I just realized I've just blocked myself in on this side. That's actually not going to make it easy to be able to work on both sides. All right, I should be able to just go ahead and do this. Granted, I'm not using a shovel like I should for that. It's at least going to be good. Okay, so let's see. I need to place down a redstone torch down right here. I actually, you know what? I probably should actually go to sleep because they probably would appreciate that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. All right, so let's see. Is anyone else gonna be in bed? All right, I actually don't know if, because there's another person on the realm right now, and it's actually, I think it's GMEX, if I'm not mistaken. And Desolate Karma, by the way, that's actually Mozart, who just recently opened up a building shop. So basically, we can hire him in order to build certain things. However, personally, I prefer building things myself. I feel like it is a little bit, how do I want to put this? Basically, I feel a little bit more accomplished if I actually am able to build it myself. Go and tell him about this, because I'm sure Mozart would actually appreciate that. There we go. Right now, this project is actually not overly complicated, all things considered. Although there are a few people who don't understand redstone, and therefore it doesn't make any sense to them. Okay, so I need to place a redstone torch down right here. So if I place the redstone torch like this, this should activate the double piston extender. Yep, and it did. Okay, so what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to climb back up here. If I can actually place the blocks down, there we go. Come on. Thank you. All right, so if I place a piece of redstone dust down right here, if I go ahead and place the button down right here, let me just test this double piston extender. Okay, the double piston extender is at least working. That's good. Now the next step is for me to build the actual block swapper itself, which I need to put a redstone torch there, and I need to place a redstone torch there. So now what I need to do is I need to take these droppers. The droppers are going to be facing upwards, like not there. You don't go right there. I need you to be one block over. All right, let's try this again. There we go, that worked. And I did not mean to put that in there. All right, I need to do the same thing on the other side. There we go. All right, so now if I get out my hoppers, which I've got six of them, I need to place a hopper right there. That's going to create a monostable circuit. And if I go ahead and pull out my dirt again, I'm going to place a dirt block right here, and I need a comparator coming out right here. And I literally just realized I did not grab anything to have these comparators be able to read. I'm gonna have to do that. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. I actually made a few items of which I'm gonna use in order to do that. It's not in that chest. There we go. So I need one, two, three, four of these. All right. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go back down. So the first thing I need to do, I need to go inside of here and place a stick. And I need to go to the other side and do the exact same thing. So that's gonna go right there. And then I need a block here. I need a block here. And I need to do the same thing on the other side. Block here. A block here. And I do not have enough redstone torches in order to finish this. That's fine. I have plenty of redstone. I should be able to do that. So I do believe I only need four redstone torches in order to finish this off. So if I go in here, someone's outside. Let me go ahead and press this button here. Actually, you know what? I should probably go ahead and show him how he can get in. So if we go ahead and press this button right here, hopefully he gets the message. All right. I've got the stick stuff to make the redstone torches. Now I know I was a little bit silent there. I was trying to determine what he was trying to do. If I go ahead and place these in here, go ahead and get out the redstone torches, make like this. That made no sense, but whatever. I need to place a redstone torch here. I need to place a redstone torch there. And I need to do the same thing on the other side. Redstone torch here, and a redstone torch not there. That is not where you need to go. You need to go on top of the block. There we go. That's better. All right. So now I need to put a block right there. I need to put a block right there. If I go ahead and come up here, I need to place down a comparator right here. I need to do the same thing on the other side. So if I go ahead and put that there, this comparator there. There we go. I've honestly never built one of these in survival before. I've only built this in creative. I'm just now realizing how complicated this actually is. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to place that there temporarily, and that did what I didn't want it to do. So if I go ahead and place the hopper there, and I go ahead and pick that up. Need to go ahead and place down. Actually, before I do that, let me go ahead and pick up my dirt block from up there. There we go. So now if I go ahead and go in here, place this facing right there. There we go. And I need to do the same thing on the other side. So if I place a block here, this is gonna come. Place the hopper. If I can reach, I'm gonna place the hopper there. And if I go ahead and break this, hopper's gonna go right there. And is he down here? Yeah, he's down here. All right, so let's go ahead and fill in these hoppers. I'm gonna place one on this side, and I'm gonna place one on this side. There we go, and that should be everything all completely done. So now if I go ahead and fill this in. I should have everything all completely done. And I should probably fill this in with dirt because that's what's right there. I'm going to go ahead and place that there. Come on, place it. My Mojang apparently broke a couple of things. Alright, so let's go ahead and fill in the floor back. So now that should be everything all completely done, I'm assuming. So if I place this right here, place this right there, and then I have this that goes right here, and then these two go right there, and there we go. My floor is now fixed. Now the next step I need to do is actually place in what I'm actually going to be swapping these blocks out with. So I'm going to place this crafting table right here. If I press this button, this should go ahead and put that there. And if I go ahead and grab a chest, which I'm surprised I don't have any chests, but whatever. I can actually go ahead and make more chests. It's not a huge deal. Don't even know what happened to all my chests, to be completely honest. So if I go ahead and turn these... Actually, I should probably get my crafting table back out. There we go. So if I go ahead and place the wood in here, just like this, there we go, we've got ourselves a chest. Go ahead and press this button. Place the chest right there, there we go. And there, we should be good. So here's what I'm going to do. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to put up most of the stuff that I have in my inventory, and then I should be actually good to start moving things over. So let me go ahead and put all this stuff away. So I put the redstone up like this, and I don't know why he decided to go ahead and give me the I do need to be in here. I don't know why he decided to give me the melons, but you know what? It's kind of whatever. Alright. So now if I go ahead and take all this stuff out, this is actually now going to end up going inside of this new chest. Is there glowstone underneath the slabs? No torches. Alright, so let's go ahead and put all this stuff inside of here. And if we go ahead and fill this back up. There we go. There we go. And now we've got ourselves a nice little thing going right here. That's actually not too complicated of a redstone machine, all things considered. Then again, I know there are people out there who don't honestly understand redstone whatsoever. But I will go ahead and say it is a very simple machine, all things considered. And that project did not take near as long. Well, actually, that project took a lot longer than I thought it was going to take. So actually, what I'm going to do is, this is something that I do in my survival series, which I probably ought to sleep before I do this. Reason why I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of fishing is mainly because I have a shop that I need to go ahead and fill up. And if I can get stuff going in the shop, that's at least good. But I don't know how much stuff I actually have in order to start filling up the shop. So I have 7 fish. Actually, you know what? Instead of doing that, what I'm actually going to do instead is I'm actually going to check to see if there's like anything I got in my shop. And I just realized that is... There we go. I just realized that I actually had my chest up. So what I'm actually going to do to finish this off is I'm going to check my shop to see if maybe if someone's bought anything since the last time I was here. And by the way, I haven't mentioned this in this video just yet, but Mozart actually did a lot of fishing and donated a lot of stuff to me, so I do want to go ahead and thank him for that. He said that I didn't need to pay him back for any of the stuff he donated. I can keep all the proceeds for what he gave me. So let me just double check to see like if anyone's bought anything so far. And by the look of things, no one. I don't think anyone. Okay, so apparently someone bought a fishing rod from me. That's actually not too bad. Anyone bought any fish so far? No, and no. Okay, so that's actually not too bad. Someone actually went ahead and bought a fishing rod from me. That's actually not too bad. But you know what? With that out of the way, I think this is actually where I'm gonna go ahead and end off the video. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed. If you did, make sure that like button. One more than make sure that subscribe button for future content. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at AgentCP0 to stay updated. This has been Zero Studios. Thank you guys for watching, and with that, I will see you guys later.